Let's review acid additions to alkynes. So with alkynes, we have an extra pi bond, which means we have the ability to react twice. And it turns out that due to the mechanism, we also are going to get anti-addition of the H and the Cl of the acid. And so if we look at the product of the first addition of HCl, one equivalent, we see that we are also a Markovnikov type addition. We add to the more substituted carbon of a terminal alkyne. However, if we have an internal alkyne, we are going to get anti-addition where the H and the Cl are on opposite sides, but we also now no longer have a preference for Markovnikov versus anti, and so we're going to get two different products. For the addition of one equivalent of our HCl. What if we add excess? Well, we just do it again. So for the internal, we get one product, and we get rid of all stereochemistry, okay? And although we didn't have any to begin with, okay, no EZ for the first addition here because it's, like we said, a terminal alkyne, but we also get no RNS because we put two chlorines. It's not a chiral center. For the internal alkyne, if we add again, likewise, keep track of our carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We lose any stereochemistry we had in the first example, or in the addition of the first equivalent. Okay, so another HCl here. We could say HCl excess and go straight to the final products here. But we add to the same chlorine, Markovnikov fashion, and it turns out that the chlorine activates this position relative to the neighboring position, which is equally substituted with carbons, but the chlorine has a stabilizing effect, as we'll see from the mechanism. And here is that mechanism. So I show pi complex formation with a molecular orbital theory approach in mind, where the pi bond in a three-center pi bond associates itself with the HCl, and it forms the pi complex as so. And we show a dotted line because it's a partial bond. Hydrogen cannot handle more than two electrons at a time. But we make a partial bond, and we also make this a partial bond. And at each center, we have a little partial charge that goes with it. And I'm going to show the biggest partial charge, the delta plus, on the more substituted Markovnikov position here, because that's going to designate where the chlorine adds. And so with our pi complex, and so when we invoke the addition of the halide at this more substituted position, in the past we've put an electron pair up into the bond with the hydrogen that adds to the carbon with the more hydrogens according to Markovnikov's rule. But here with the pi complex, what we essentially have is a molecular orbital that has two electrons in it and shares three atoms. So this is not an easy thing to represent with a Lewis structure, which represents a valence bond type theory process. So what we do know is that the chlorine's going to leave. So two electrons go with the chlorine. But to show the bond formation, we really have to show both of these partial bonds
forming the bond to carbon and hydrogen here. And so not easy to represent, but I'm going to show it with kind of a two-tailed, single-headed arrow. Single arrow, remember, in organic chemistry mechanisms represents two electrons moving. So if I merge the two electrons from two different places into one arrow, we're still only representing a two-electron movement. Okay, so this is a little bit different representation than you're going to see elsewhere. And so for my class, this is what I want to see. And we form the intermediate structure here with a single addition of a halide. We're done. Okay, so this is it. One HCl has added because haloalkenes, such as this fellow, are less reactive than alkenes. So we could stop here if we wanted to, but let's keep going and add one more equivalent HCl. And so this is going to follow from our old chapter. Okay, just alkene additions. Form the carbocation of the more substituted carbon. Turns out that the carbon with the chlorine is an excellent carbon to put a carbocation here. Won't show the brackets this time for clarity, but the reason is, and I'll show a resonance contributor, the double-headed arrow represents a resonance contributor, where the chlorine donates a lone pair to the cation in order to stabilize it. So this is a relatively stable cation here. Not the resonance contributor is not part of the mechanism, but it is a key feature. So then we invoke another halide, which will add in the Markovnikov position, and writing everything upright, we end up with our geminal dihalide. No stereocenter formed.